The Materials Innovation and Learning Laboratory, or the MIL, at Georgia Tech is the world's first open-access, student-run, make-and-measure space for material science and engineering. In the MIL, students have access to state-of-the-art equipment that they'll find commonly in the discipline, in scientific labs, industry labs. They get to learn to process materials, characterize their chemistry, their structure, measure their properties. They also get to learn about how to work with other people, how to lead people, how to manage people, how to work together and come up with new ideas that can better the world.
What differentiates the MIL from other maker spaces is that it is really a make and measure space, where students are not just interested in making the material, but also characterizing its structure and testing its properties so that they get a better perspective on what is it that makes the material perform in the manner it does.
When we started the MIL, we were going to use whatever equipment we could find. But today, they have new DSCs, new SEMs, and these kids get to learn how to use this equipment that'll be value added for the rest of their career. As an interviewer from industry, it was really exciting to see a student have the MIL on their resume. Beth's experience in the MIL totally separated her from the pack. She had experience working with different equipment that was applicable, and we're lucky to have her because she could have gotten any job she wanted.
Through my experience at the MIL, I've learned how to interact with people, use some really cool equipment. I was looking around on the Material Science and Engineering website and I saw the list of the different teams and the equipment. And then I saw the scanning electron microscope listed, and I could not believe that there was an SEM listed on the website. And I'd found a community in the MIL. I found friends, and so I came for the SEM and I stayed for the people.
I am a biomedical engineering major, and the MIL is very important to me because it's where a lot of my friends are and it's where my community is. Through leading the MIL as a chief operating officer, I was able to develop my skill as a communicator, as a public speaker, and a manager.
I was first introduced to the MIL through the Science of Art team. It really caught my attention because they partner creativity with science. We work with glass fusing, epoxy, resin, even alcohol inks, and it's really about getting down on the scientific level and learning why these things happen and making art out of it.
My summer research position is about 3D printing Mars soil and using Mars soil to create structures that hopefully will be eventually used on Mars. I'll be using the same 3D printers that we have at the MIL, and being on leadership and having these skills really is what pushed me over the edge for this program.
When I think about the future of the MIL, I think about the ability to expand multifold, such a strong talent pool of students who will go off and change the world, especially being able to work cross-disciplinary. That to me is amazing. We have facilities to really foster all of these students with varied interests coming together to really spark new innovation in different areas that probably have not been seen before.
When I think about the future of the MIL, I'm very inspired. It's about the knowledge and curiosity that it fosters and nurtures so that these students are better equipped for the next big idea.
The future of the MIL is to transform education in material science and engineering. And we want to see a space, a new space, that creates more discovery. It's open. Glass. One student sees another student doing something and says, hey, I want to learn about that. That's what we want to get. We want to bring everyone together and discover more. The students in the MIL are already leaders. They're already innovators, technical experts, community builders. And what we need is a space to match that.
I like to ask our alumni, friends, and industrial partners to help us secure the funding needed to expand the MIL, to make it a highly interactive, modern facility to transform materials education and indeed transform tomorrow.